In the Dragon Ball franchise, the main character Son Goku has achieved incredible power. And one of the means of bringing out this great power has been through Goku's transformations. The ability for him to go through a physical metamorphosis that magnifies his already substantial power many-fold. And with each new form comes a level of power that allows him to transcend beyond any previous limitations that his body was capable of. These forms have allowed Goku to battle against the most powerful enemies in the multiverse, and surpass his friends and rivals time and time again. But what if I told you that Goku's greatest strength is also his greatest weakness, and something that enemies could exploit to devastating effect? Well, in this video, I'm going to discuss that. But before I begin, I want to tell you all about today's great sponsor, Surfshark VPN. Now, if you guys are anything like me, then you love to watch anime, be it the Dragon Ball franchise or beyond. However, depending upon where you live in the world, that may not actually be an option, because of things like geo-blocking and platforms limiting where people are able to watch their content from. As a result, you may not be able to see your favorite shows. However, thanks to Surfshark VPN, you can instantly resolve this problem by using Surfshark to change your location in order to access content which you normally wouldn't be able to, such as if you were to go on Netflix and change your location to Japan, instantly giving you access to all of the content you weren't able to get to before, including the great new Blu-ray remasters of Dragon Ball Z's movies. But not only that, but when you're surfing the internet, be it on your computer, phone, or other device, your data and information will be completely secure due to Surfshark's incredible data encryption capabilities, which will keep hackers and thieves from stealing your data as well as your identity. I've used Surfshark myself in the past, and it's really been great, giving me a safe feeling and peace of mind and the ability to get around so many of these barriers, all at an affordable price. And speaking of that, thanks to Surfshark, I'm able to bring you a great deal, where you can get Surfshark for 83% off with 4 extra months free, all as a part of their special Christmas offer. Simply enter the code LAUGHINGSTOCK at checkout and you'll be able to get this great offer. So head on down to the description and use the special link so that you can get Surfshark VPN and begin protecting your data and watching more content right now. And with that being said, let's get into this topic. Now, in order to properly discuss this subject, I have to first talk about Goku's transformations and how they work. Now, pretty much every single transformation that Goku utilizes, be it Super Saiyan 1 through 3, Super Saiyan God, or Blue, are all different types of multipliers. They are all things that increases Goku's base power, which is to say his normal form, by many-fold, and typically stack on top of one another. So, much like the Kaioken, Goku's Super Saiyan is also a multiplier of 50 times. His Super Saiyan 2, 2 times that for 100 times the base. His Super Saiyan 3 is 4 times that for 400 times his base form. And of course, Super Saiyan God and Super Saiyan Blue have their own multipliers, which we haven't been told yet, and who knows if they ever actually will tell us what those forms actually multiply his power by. But the thing is that when you actually look at this, it is an incredible increase in strength that Goku has every time he goes into these forms. And you could say the same thing for Ultra Instinct, because there are many people who believe that Ultra Instinct does not give Goku an increase in power. But if you actually look at the anime interpretation of it, as well as the manga, you see that Goku's power definitely increases, as he taps into his deeper instinctual levels of power. So Ultra Instinct Omen, and of course the Mastered or Complete Ultra Instinct, also gives him greater levels of power, in addition to his ability to move and react to opponents and dodge their attacks, as well as attacking instinctively. However, the thing is, when you really take a look at Goku himself, you start to see that this, in and of itself, is also kind of a weakness. Because the truth is that Goku's true form is his base form. A form which, in and of itself, is many thousands, or who knows, millions of times weaker at this point, than his strongest form. And if Goku ever has to encounter enemies that require him to transform in order to fight him, then that's where things start to become an issue. Because the truth of the matter is, even though we see typically in Dragon Ball, in the Dragon Ball franchise, that characters allow other characters to go into their forms, and Goku cycles through his forms in pretty much every single fight, the problem is that if Goku really encounters enemies that say, forget that, I'm not gonna allow him to do that, that becomes a major issue. Because even though Goku's base power has increased significantly over the course of this story, going from a very weak power level of just being able to pick up cars and tank bullets and things like that, to now being able to probably destroy the entire universe and many other ones on top of that in just his base form, the fact of the matter is that when characters that Goku fights are increasingly escalating in power and pushing him to his maximum, that means that all of them would hypothetically and realistically be able to instantly one-shot him in his base form. And the same thing can be said for pretty much everyone surrounding Goku who's always attempting to keep up. Many people look at characters like Krillin or Piccolo or Tien or, you know, Master Roshi, all these other fighters as being weak compared to Goku. But as we saw in the Tournament of Power, the next arc, and, you know, as we've seen with characters like Gohan, like Hit, and other allies that Goku's made along the way, even though he might be way more powerful than them at his maximum in his ultimate state, his final form as it is right now, because they're always adding more of them, the fact of the matter is that many of them could probably one-shot him in his base form. Because the fact that they know that Goku's weakness is in and of itself the fact that he has to go into those forms in order to really be a threat to them or in order to overcome them. So realistically, Hit could just show up and hit Goku one time right in the neck, instantly taking him out. And the same thing could be said for Jiren and pretty much everyone else. Regardless of the fact that Goku himself has surpassed them in his higher forms, and, you know, obviously his base increases and people have those debates, oh, base Goku is now stronger than Ultra Instinct, etc., etc. You know, we know the power scaling in this franchise can be pretty insane, especially in Dragon Ball Super. The fact of the matter is that if a character is stronger than even Goku's Super Saiyan form, or his Super Saiyan 2, which, of course, in the grand scheme of things, isn't much compared to his greatest form, they could still utterly annihilate him if he doesn't go into a form that is equivalent to them or higher. So really, this leaves Goku open to being able to be taken out by so many foes along the way. And not to mention that because of the fact that Goku often cycles through his forms, and because of the fact that he has to tap into his ultimate state from his base form, there's always a time disparity. There's always an opening that he can be attacked during. And no matter how fast he's able to go into these forms, where it's almost instant, during that period of time when characters are moving millions or trillions of times faster than the speed of light, it doesn't really make much of a difference just how fast he's tapping into them, because he's incredibly vulnerable. Another problem is that in Dragon Ball Super, the idea of resting defenses, the idea that a character's aura and their power is so great that regardless of what form they're in, they're still able to tank a lot of damage, even if they're completely caught off guard, has in of itself kind of been eliminated. Where we see that Goku, for example, in the Dragon Ball Super anime in the Tournament of Power, right before it at least, was able to be harmed by bullets when he wasn't paying attention. Bullets, something that couldn't really even hurt him when he was a kid. It was more of an inconvenience or an annoyance to him. But in Dragon Ball Super, that's obviously not the case anymore, and Goku can be killed by a common ray gun. Although that also happens even when he lets his guard down in Super Saiyan Blue if we go by the Dragon Ball Z movie Resurrection F. So the thing is that Goku's forms, even though they give him incredible advanced power, are not actually something that is protecting him when he is in his weaker or lower states, or really his true form. Goku is not like Gohan, for example. With Gohan's ultimate, at least originally, wasn't supposed to be an additional form. It was just that he didn't need to transform to tap into his true full power. So as a result, there wasn't really that kind of limitation or that time period where Gohan needed to tap into all these other forms after he got his potential unlocked by the Elder Supreme Kai. Rather, instead, he was able to go full power pretty much right away in that base form without that kind of disparity, without that weakness, and able to fight against his enemies. Of course, because the franchise has pretty much kind of done nothing with Gohan for the most part ever since the Buu saga, the thing is that ultimately Gohan's plot armor and plot relevance has significantly diminished any kind of capabilities he has in terms of defeating the main villain or doing practically anything of use other than kind of showing up and saying, I'm stronger now, and then getting beaten by the main villain so Goku can look better. But yet, Goku probably would still gain a lot from borrowing this kind of idea from his son, from getting his potential fully unlocked so that he wouldn't have to transform anymore in order to get into his full power. And of course, there is also the God Key aspect of it. You know, you do question whether or not Goku would need to transform into, you know, God forms, even if he had the ultimate state, because it probably doesn't unlock his pure God Ki potential, because, of course, Goku doesn't inherently have God Ki. It's more of him actually powering up all of his ki within his body in attaining that sort of state with God and Super Saiyan Blue. And you can argue Ultra Instinct, even though that's kind of been dubious whether or not he even is using full-on God ki in that form. And that, again, is another reason why those God forms in and of themselves are also weaknesses. Because Goku really needs to get to a point at this point in the series where he has full mastery of God ki and is able to use it 24/7 like the gods do. Like Supreme Kai, like Beerus, like the angels, and not have to go through a process of actually creating and augmenting it within his body. Much like right now we see that he's working on mastering Ultra Instinct even beyond the silver-haired form, so to speak, that he uses, at the same time he should be doing the same thing with God Ki. Because the fact that he has to go through a process is exactly the same issue that he has in terms of transforming, where he also has to spend additional time powering up his energy within his body. During that time, he's also vulnerable, because enemies who can't sense God Ki are able to sense his normal energy. So again, when we look at that, these are two different major weaknesses, both tied to his transformations, which are ultimately limiting Goku. In another angle you can approach this is by looking at Goku's base power compared to the power of many people around him. I already brought up characters like Gohan and Piccolo before, who are both more powerful drastically than Goku's base power, at least until they give him massive power-ups and they make the other characters irrelevant around him. But of course, the characters themselves often do catch up, at least surpassing Goku's base power, to seem somewhat relevant in this kind of endless cycle that Dragon Ball Super has been doing. But again, when you really look at Goku's true power, or at least his base power in his normal form, this means that if Goku has to fight a character who pushes him to his limits, then he is millions, billions, trillions, and who knows what multiplier they're using at this point, times weaker than his opponent in his real form, compared to his opponents who most of the time don't even have to transform in order to fight him. Most of the villains that Goku fights at this point don't have to transform in order to fight him at his maximum, or at least they don't have to transform in order to be significantly more powerful than he is in his lower forms. Again, we could bring up Hit, who is an antagonist that Goku faced in the past, and now basically an ally of his, who was able to rival Goku's Super Saiyan Blue in his Kaioken, and then is at least comparable now to his Blue or Super Saiyan God forms, and yet is still able to ultimately annihilate him if you compare them in terms of base, right here, in Hit's form all the way up here. So the thing is that, again, this just shows you how Goku's greatest strength is ultimately in many ways his greatest weakness. Because if Goku eliminated the need to transform at all, and if he also eliminated the need to transform his ki into God ki, and he was able to do those things and use his full power in his true base form the entire time, then he would be without this weakness. He would not only have, you know, Ultra Instinct and these other things that are getting rid of his other weaknesses, like being caught off guard, which Super tells us is his greatest weakness, although obviously there's many arguments against that, including this video right here, but it would also make it to where there isn't such a massive disparity between Goku's true form and, of course, all the people who fight around him, including his allies and his enemies. And the fact that Goku has had to tap into all these forms has also probably held back in many ways his base form's progression. Because Goku constantly, especially in Dragon Ball Super, has focused on mastering forms like Super Saiyan Blue, especially in the manga, and, you know, getting to Ultra Instinct being mastered with essentially what's a form. I know that a lot of people don't like to call it a form, but again, it transforms his hair color, he gets a whole new aura and state of being. That seems like a form to me and pretty much most other people who actually use the transformation word literally. So again, Goku wouldn't have this weakness at all if he were to overcome that and simply be in his base, much like we saw when he was fighting Ub at the end of Z. He didn't transform into a Super Saiyan or anything like that, he just stayed in his base. And I think that that would be the best way for Goku to go in the future. Now, obviously, there's a big chance that this probably won't happen, as I've talked about in the past with my video talking about why Dragon Ball Super should abandon transformations, because ultimately, the biggest motivator behind Goku and these other characters, especially the Saiyans having new forms and, you know, Ultra Instinct, Ultra Ego, all these new brand new forms, these shiny new things that you can slap on merchandise, is exactly that. Merchandise and marketing. It's almost all out of universe. You can argue in-universe that Saiyans, when they need to reach a certain level of power, have to transform, but again, pretty much every single time Goku's base form surpasses one of his highest forms from a previous arc, or from arcs previously before that, you kind of see that that argument is in of itself moot. And as a result, it's more about Toei and Shueisha and all the people behind Dragon Ball trying to sell new marketable forms and new transformations and new things with merchandise and video games and all these things. And of course, much of the fan base does enjoy these new forms, but really, when it comes to Goku himself as a fighter, it really should not be about tapping into new forms and simply getting stronger. It should be mastering himself and who he is, not just in his base form, but as a martial artist, in terms of technique and in terms of strength, all trying to equalize all of them at the same time. So, ultimately, I think in this video I've shown why Goku's greatest strength in his transformations is also his greatest weakness, something that could easily be exploited by characters who don't just allow him to transform and do whatever he wants for the sake of the plot, especially if it were to come time to fight in versus battles, for example, against characters from other universes. Because oftentimes people like to put Goku in his most powerful form and his greatest feats against other characters doing the same thing. But realistically, if someone who is stronger than Goku's base form just wanted to take him out, they could probably do so pretty quickly because of the fact that Goku is limited by the ability or by the fact that he actually has to transform in order to reach his truest power, or at least his full power. So let me know your own thoughts down below in the comments. Do you agree with this or disagree?
And don't forget to go down below to the description and use the special link as well as the code LAUGHINGSTOCK so that you can get Surfshark VPN.
Thanks for watching and make sure to stick around because there's a lot more to come in the future.
Yeah, and you better subscribe.